class. Now we will see the construction and working of AC CDI type ignition system. On the slide we can see the circuit diagram of our AC CDI. Okay, so this is a schematic diagram which we can use to draw in exam. How exactly the AC CDI look like we will see in the further slides. Okay, but right now just we will go through the construction. Okay, so here we are starting the construction. This is a magneto, or we can say it is a AC generator which is located on the crankshaft. Basically, as I told you, in the case of the construction working of starting system of motorcycle, okay, this AC generator is located on the crankshaft, left side of crankshaft, okay, and it having your poles, two poles or two, or we can say two magnets, or it's arranged in such a way that it forms a two south and two north pole, okay. Even though it having some notches over here, okay, it having some notch, or we can say it having a peak of certain width, okay. This peak of certain width indicating, okay, what is the position of piston from the top dead center, okay. So it just a triggering tick which in this diagram taken out here, okay. This is a peak which we have taken out here, and this triggering coil supposed to locate here. In case of actual case, just for the understanding or simplicity purpose, we have just taken out this thing separate from main magneto. But actually, it is actually, if you see this thing in motorcycle, you will find this peak present. This peak, and this is earth here. This peak, okay, actually located on the magneto itself, and this winding or the pickup point is located over here. Just for the understanding purpose, we have just take it out here. Okay, so we repeat up all those things. So can imagine this thing also present on the here only this peak. Okay, and this pickup coil is present over here. So this is magnet with pickup coil. Even though there is a various coils are present near to this magnet. Some are lightning coil, some are the starting coil, some are the pickup coil. So this is the pickup coil which is located here. Okay, this peak is located on magneto. This is your starting coil, or we can say this is your powered coil. Okay, this is a powered coil. Okay, one more coil may be located in the in our AC generator. That is nothing but the what we can say lightning coil. On the basis of that lightning coil, your headlight or other lightning assist is supposed to get a power. Okay, so here we are only showing the two coils, such as a exciter coil, or we can say the powered coil, or we can say it is a starting coil. Okay, and this is your trigger. Now this coil, okay, is earth over here. Okay, it having a number of number of turns. This gauge thickness of this wire is very very small. Okay, it having a fine, or it is a very thin wire which is used for the starting coil, which is used for the exciter coil in order to have a high voltage developed. Okay, so after this line wire is going to the capacitor through diode here. Okay, so the capacitor goes to the capacitor through diode. After it goes to the primary circuit of your ignition coil. So this is your primary winding. Okay, again it get earth over here. So this earth, and after that this earth, the circuit get complete. Okay, we will draw again. It start from here, passing through diode, passing through capacitor. Okay, earth here, and this earth, and this earth supposed to make a circuit close. Okay, in between the path there is a diode is present. Okay, or we can say ignition switch is present. So here this ignition switch is nothing but your what keyhole. Even though here one more thing is left to show, that is nothing but your kill switch, engine kill switch. We can have one more switch here, engine kill switch. Your key switch and the ignition keys kill switch are both need to be on, then only your vehicle supposed to, or your two wheeler or motorcycle supposed to on. So this is your engine kill switch, bottom one, and this is your key switch. Okay, so these are the location of ignition switch, and this is the location of engine kill switch. After that there is a transistor used, or we can say it is a silicon control rectifier is used. Silicon control rectifier having three legs, this is a first leg, this is a second leg, and this is a third leg. Okay, so this at the third leg we are having the we have to send a recommended pulse in order to trigger this SCR. SCR only trigger whenever recommended pulse are stented at the third leg, otherwise it become non-conductive. It become only conductive whenever a suitable pulse is stented at the third leg, then only it start to conduct in this direction only, the direction in which arrow is shown. Okay, after that there is one resistor is mounted over here in order to just prevent the damage of this transistor or SCR. Okay, after that this wire, this connection come to the pickup coil or the trigger coil. Okay, this trigger coil located actually over here, we know already, and some CDI system in bit before triggering or before sending trigger signal to this transistor or SCR, there is one control unit is located over here. Okay, as I told you in previous video, ECU is there or ignition unit is there. So this ECU or microprocessor may present over here, it having again some inputs from the other sensor like our engine coolant temperature sensor, throttle position sensor. Okay, TPS is there, engine coolant temperature sensor is there. So this controller is present before at the third leg of your SCR. Okay, it's also taking the pickup from the triggering coil, so it calculating all those input on that and compare it those calculation with the engine map and respect to optimum time of triggering is centered to the third leg of the SCR. Okay, so in that way in some unit or some CDI, okay, conventional CDI, in case of the conventional CDI this control unit was not there, but in case of the, I told you in the first slide only, CDI unit may come into the electronic ignition system also and into program ignition system also. So whenever we are using ECU over here in order to calculate optimum time, okay, that time it is called as a program one. Whenever this ECU is not there, directly this pickup coil signal are forwarded to the SCR third leg, then it become a electronic CDI. So now in our case shown on the slide, the ECU is not present over here. It is not there. Okay, so it is absent. So this CDI comes under the electronic ignition system, where triggering is only what we can say electronic, not program. Any kind of program is fed into the ECU or controlled by ECU that ignition system. Okay, so here the ECU is not there. So here we are, we can say this is our electronic ignition CDI is there. Okay, after that this is our primary winding and this is our secondary winding, which having more number of turn as compared to our primary winding, and it is sent it to the spark plug. So other end of the ignition coil is primary secondary winding is negative terminal of spark plug, and the another other end of your ignition secondary ignition coil is connected to the positive end of our spark plug. In between those two end, our voltage of 21k or 21k to 30k supposed to jump to make a visible spark for seconds. So that much voltage are supposed to jump across our spark plug. Okay, so still here we have completed construction of our EC CDI system. Still if you feel any difficulty to understand some concepts, ask me on your Google Classroom. Thank you.